today is Vlogmas day 12, I think. Yeah, 12. It is the afternoon. It's almost 2 o'clock. I slept to almost 12:30 because the previous night, all I did was sleep for at least like 2.5 hours and I was up to like 10 p.m. So my body was tired. And plus I had a migraine yesterday that was really bad. So I needed to sleep it off. But maybe today I'll just show what we got from Lush yesterday because we went to the mall. And got some items from Lush because, as you can see, our bathtub in the back. I've been wanting to take a bath. Well, he wants me to relax too, so we always go get some bath bombs and some bath soaps or bath bubbles, whatever it's called. I have to find the name and I'll link it in the screen. So basically, like the bath bubbles or whatever it is, you can break off little pieces and it gives you like the true bubbles. Where else the bath bombs just change the color and it has like stuff inside of it. And that's about it. Also, we need to mount our TV, so maybe I'll show that as well. But I don't know what today's gonna bring. My life is boring. I really don't do much. But since it's the holiday season, I've been going out more trying to find decor for our home. Just regular stuff. So we'll see what today brings. Like I said, my day's just running together. I had to ask Alexa what day it was because I didn't know. So just stay tuned and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I hope you're enjoying all my Vlogmas content. It's been really fun. I told my friend, like, I've been learning a lot. I've been trying to do different editing as well. And I'm just having a great time.
I want to show off my socks. I love fuzzy socks. Like I said, since we want to do no shoes in our house, I think I'm gonna buy a whole bunch of these socks. So
this is what our living room is looking like. This is all of his Black Friday purchases that we haven't opened yet. And the bottom box is mine. This is what we got from Lush. And then we started, well, he started to lay out how we want to mount our TV. Right now, since we've been moving in, we have this 60-inch TV that we just kept on the floor because we didn't want to mount it and then we were going to take it off. And he got this 75-inch TV. I'll link the TV in the description box. And he got this from Best Buy on Black Friday. So we're gonna mount this TV in our living room right here. And this is my tree. I can't get over it. I love it so much. I feel like there's more I could add, but it's our first Christmas in our homes. And plus this ribbon right here, I had a hard time finding it. So this is what our kitchen's looking like. It's real life. Like I said, we were trying to mount the TV. So that stuff that's on the counter is all for the TV mount. But I'm gonna clear that all. I don't understand, like, how do these workers work on the weekend? Like, today is Saturday. So that's the only downfall about living in a new construction community, because you will constantly have construction, especially for us. On the street that we built on, I think we were the fourth house on the street. You can just imagine like how many other houses have to be built on the street. Like right now there's one being built directly beside us and there's two more lots on the other side of us. And then there's still more lots down the street and around the corner. So we're in a construction zone probably for the next year, which isn't bad. I don't understand why they work on the weekend. I mean, I understand they're trying to move the process along to get people houses done, but the resident people like us, we need to be able to not hear construction every damn day. Sorry, shouldn't say that. But yeah, we shouldn't be able to hear construction every day. Sometimes it's loud, sometimes it's not. It depends on if they're, right now they're doing the framing on two different houses, one behind us, one down on another street, but it's like on the right of us. Like we can hear the nailing and the hammering, but it gets loud when they do bricking because they have to cut the brick and it just gets too much. But that's my little rant. Sorry, we'll get back to cleaning. Well, not really cleaning the kitchen. The kitchen's clean, but cleaning off the counter. And he just got back with groceries. Thank you.
the store with so much stuff that I don't know what all he has. Bought some eggs. We like to eat the organic brown eggs, some asparagus, and sandwich meats because he likes to eat sandwiches. So he got some turkey breast, some smoked turkey, and it smells pretty good. And then some Kobe Jack cheese.
That's for you, baby.
He said that was for me, if you heard him. He got some fresh broccoli, and then he got some slider buns. I'm assuming he got these so he can make the little sandwiches that I made last week, where you toast them in the oven. And his favorite thing, he got chips. So he got some plain Lay's, some dill pickle. I like dill pickles, but I believe I never had the Lay's dill pickle. And salt and vinegar. Then he got some 2% milk because we got a whole bunch of donuts yesterday. Then he got some Arby's curly fries. And then some pepper jack cheese, which I like. And some heavy whipping cream. Don't know what he got that for.
We're gonna put that in hot cocoa.
Oh, okay. And then he got...
You know how, like, whenever they put it in, they do the little...
He got some more mayo. This is the brand mayo he likes. So, since moving to Texas, I eat this mayo, too. And then he got some medium cheddar cheese.
And he got some honey wheat loaf of bread. And he got some wheat rolls. This is what he likes to eat with his sandwiches. And some pork thighs, sort of fat. Then he got some Brussels sprouts, because we've been talking about Brussels sprouts.
And then he got me some poinsettias because I believe he's trying to say that this one is dying. Then he got me some flowers.
Aww.
So as you can see, the white ones has glitter on them, but they're really pretty.
He was like, yeah, you need to start posting their videos in Discord. Like, Drew, you might want to just start being a promoter or something. Like, that's the type of fans you want. You want Drew.
Let's see what we got from Lush. I don't know the name of the products we got. I will link the name across the screen, also in the description box. So these are the bath bombs he picked out. So he got this one. I think this one's like a galaxy something. And then he got this one, like of the names. And this one. I do know the name of this one. This is the sex bomb one. So he got those three. I got this one. So this one, I forgot the name of it, but I've used this one before as well. And this one is the Twilight one. So no, these are the bubble bars. So basically, like, you can just run this underneath the water and you'll get a lot of bubbles. But we asked the people in the store, so they basically said, like, you can break off a small piece and you can just drop it into your bath instead of using the whole bar, because these last pretty long. And then we have this one. He picked out these, but this one we thought was pretty cute since I'm from Georgia. It's a peach. Like, look at it. So we got these from Lush.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. In one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
I'm feeling my camera.
would even say it goes. All of the other rainbows used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you ride my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer.